This is an original Italian poster for the 1955 film East of Eden with James Dean. This poster had heavy folio creases, and we flattened it out on a linen backing at Posterfix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to Posterfix Studio. Today, we have a very fantastic vintage poster that you're going to see us linen back and restore, but before we get started on that, I just wanted to tell you that if you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage poster, send me an email. Tell me its size, tell me the poster's condition, and send me a few photos if you can, and I'll get back to you with a price for linen backing and restoration. I look forward to seeing your poster. Now let's get moving with this project.
Let's see, when I got this East of Eden poster, it was all folded up, but boy, it looks clean and bright and in really good condition. So I think all I'm gonna have to do is linen back it. The back of it is clean. Look at that.
So, the only thing wrong with this poster, boy, it's mint. It looks like it's never been used. All it's got are these folio folds, so we're going to linen back it to flatten it out. First, I have to prepare a screen. Right, James?
This is a sheet of acid-free paper, and this is going to be what the poster is mounted to. But before I do that, I have to mount this piece of paper to the cotton canvas. And so I'm applying wheat paste. This is sort of the same kind of wheat paste that's used in wallpaper, except this is a finer grade, which is sold for conservation work and is especially good for linen backing. And then I lift it up and mount it to this canvas.
James Byron Dean was born in February of 1931 and died in September of 1955, and he was an American actor. For those of you who don't know, he is remembered as a cultural icon of teenage disillusionment and social estrangement, as expressed in the title of his most celebrated film, Rebel Without a Cause, from 1955, in which he starred as a troubled teenager, Jim Stark. The other two roles that defined his stardom were loner Carl Trask of East of Eden, this poster, and surly ranch hand Jeff Rink in Giant, 1956. After his death in a car crash in September of 1955, James Dean became the first actor to receive a posthumous Academy Award nomination for Best Actor for his role in East of Eden.
And now I'm using a roller to gently roll out the acid-free paper so that it really sticks to the canvas without any air pockets or excessive wheat paste. Many people ask me if I can use a different color paper as the backing paper. Well, the answer is sort of no, yes and no. For me to get the proper archival effect, I need to use this specific paper for linen backing, which is a bleached white. Really have a choice. Now, if you really insist on having a colored paper as a background, I can find colored paper, but it won't necessarily be of the same quality as this paper. It may be heavier, especially if I try to find it as an acid-free paper. It cuts my options down a little bit, but not much.
Upon receiving a second nomination for his role in Giant the following year, Dean became the only actor to have had two posthumous acting nominations. In 1999, the American Film Institute ranked him the 18th best male movie star of Golden Age Hollywood in AFI's 100 Years, 100 Stars list. Now that I've rolled out the acid-free paper so that there are no air pockets between the paper and the canvas, I'm trimming the excess paper off the two ends to make a nice little lip where the paper goes under the frame. And then I'm going to tuck it in there with my little spatula thingamajig. And that's it. This poster is now a screen that can have a poster linen-backed to it.
Okay, the screen has had acid-free paper mounted to it, and now we're ready for East of Eden. And you will see us mount this poster after this commercial break, so don't go away.
We're back in the Posterfix shop, and we're ready to mount East of Eden.
Size of this poster, I'm going to put the wheat paste on the acid-free paper first, rather than directly on the poster. This is in Spanish. I'm not sure what country it's from. Rome. Oh, Rome. It's Italian. Not Spanish, it's Italian. Sorry. I am too folio.
East of Eden is a 1955 American period drama film directed by Elia Kazan and loosely based on the fourth and final part of the 1952 novel of the same name by John Steinbeck. East of Eden is about a wayward young man who, while seeing his own identity, vies for the affection of his deeply religious father against his favored brother, thus retelling the story of Cain and Abel. The film stars Julie Harris, James Dean — James Dean is in his first major screen role — and Raymond Massey. It also features Burl Ives, Richard Davalos, and Joe Van Fleet, and was adapted by Paul Osborne.
Spraying it with water to help the poster begin to expand. Paper is porous, and as it absorbs water and wheat paste, it expands, and then as it dries, it contracts again into a nice tight linen backing.
Although set in the early 20th century, Monterey, California, much of the film was actually shot on location in Mendocino, California. Of the three films in which James Dean played the lead, this is the only one to have been released during his lifetime. The film, along with Dean's other films, Rebel Without a Cause and Giant, was named one of the 400 best American films of all time by the American Film Institute. In 2016, East of Eden was selected for preservation in the United States National Film Registry by the Library of Congress as being culturally, historically, or aesthetically significant. And now that I've rolled out the poster, I'm going over it with a few sponges to make sure that the face of it is free of wheat paste residue and is nice and clean. Director Alia Kazan first toyed with the idea of casting Marlon Brando as Cal and Montgomery Clift as Aaron. But at 30 and 34 years old, respectively, they were simply too old to play teenage brothers. Paul Newman, who was 1 year younger than Brando, was a finalist for the part of Cal, which eventually was played by James Dean, who was 6 years younger than Newman.
East of Eden is linen back.
Don't go away. We'll be right back. You're back at Posterfix. A few days have passed, and we've cut it down off the screen, and now we're trimming it down and doing some last color retouching. Well, that about wraps it up for today's edition of Posterfix Studio. If you haven't already, please subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell so you get informed whenever we have a new upload of a restoration project. We appreciate it, and we'll see you here next time. Thank you.